Kate Middleton's shock collapsed. In a moment no one saw coming, the Duchess of Cambridge collapsed in tears last week over the ongoing family issues and the fact that her husband, Prince William, had secretly battled coronavirus earlier this year. Last week, it emerged that William had contracted the illness in April around the same time his father, Prince Charles, caught it. The decision to keep his sickness from the public because he didn't want to worry anyone was also a controversial one, and one that meant Kate had to deal with it all on her own. Worried friends say she's been dealing with so much this year and it finally got to her last week, prompting William to come clean on his diagnosis. She's been holding it all in, doing the stiff upper lip thing to perfection, and last week it all came to a head, says an insider. It's been a tough time for the couple, but everyone tends to worry more about Wells and not about her. She's exhausted, the insider adds. It's been a hell of a lot. The Duke of Cambridge's decision to keep his coronavirus battle a secret has not been well received by everyone, with royal author Robert Johnson believing the prince showed poor judgment by not telling the truth. Prince William's decision to lie about contracting COVID-19 earlier for whatever reason is appalling, Robert wrote on Twitter. KP were asked several times by the media whether Prince William contracted the virus and were told categorically no. This has created a serious issue of trust. If the palace is prepared to lie about an issue as serious as William, second in line to the throne, contracted COVID-19, what else have they lied about the question by the press, and why should the media believe any dials doing for work? This raises serious issues. However, in the latest episode of Royal Obsessed podcast, host Robert Florido and Rachel Bowie discuss a theory as to why William's diagnosis was hushed up. Say the worst happened, the Queen at 94 passed away, when Prince Charles passed away, then Prince William passed away, all because they were hit by the virus, Robert hypothesis. The next in line to the throne is George, and when Charlotte, and then Louis, and none of them are over 18, and which is where the Regency Act comes to play. That means a regent could ruin his place, and that person has to be over 21. The next in line of succession is Prince Harry, who had just left on March 31st and moved to California and quit. Then after the Prince Harry, the next available regent is Prince Andrew, she added. Roberta's co-host Rachel then weighed in on a theory, saying like, think of what the headlines would have been. Panic is an understatement. People would obviously be spinning and hypothesizing and speculating on what could happen, playing out all of these scenarios, so I doubt it was William's choice to keep it a secret. News of William's health battle were first brought to light by the UK Sun newspaper, adding that the royal dad of three was struck down pretty hard by the virus. At one stage he was struggling to breathe, so obviously everyone around him was really panic, the source alleged. But despite his shock diagnosis, the prince was reportedly able to carry on his new regal duties while undergoing treatment at his Norfolk home. After seeing medics and testing positive, it was obviously quite a shock given how fit and healthy he is, William was determined it should be business as usual, thought, the source claimed.